check. Hopefully, I'm going to be able to hear the whole room now a little better. Mm-hmm. Let's see.
Can you guys hear us?
Yeah, I think it's better when we have it like this.
Yeah, this is a problem. When you look at it, you'll listen to this person. The actual Malachi is not, it's not exactly in the same position as the first person. Yeah. So picking up stuff is way more difficult.
Yeah.
I think we should do this.
Yeah, of course. But what is wrong with this guy? Like, look at him.
The animation?
Yeah, the animation was weird.
Yeah, it's
different
from the
anime.
No, just that, like, he's...
It's a backless.
Yeah, but that was always, and this will change when we'll have these new animations.
Yeah.
Yeah, see how we slide down?
Yeah.
So I think it's because there is this weird gravity.
Meteor storm inbound.
You know what I mean, like, but I hope they will change this with the physics and stuff. Some new bug, this.
Yeah.
He just like. Okay, that's Jerry.
So you notice when you take your helmet off, the character will always restart because it's a change of
mode. So you should
draw the zone.
When I'm like this, and I switch helmet on off, and he restarts his view. You know, like again, Tomáš, I'm looking like this. Now I'm putting on or off the helmet, I don't know, and he will do this.
Okay.
Okay.
Did you adjust the mic on? Still too quiet, apparently. Sorry. Hopefully it doesn't pick up too much. Turn down this. Turn this down to this. And that should be good.
Okay.
Well, what was wrong?
It was just when we swapped over mic, it was a little quiet. It's not as direct as the one.
Okay.
Okay, so now regarding the highlight, okay, you need to be really close.
Yeah. Because otherwise we wouldn't be able to pick it up, but maybe we could make it from a larger distance, you know. I think it would make a lot of sense also. But you see, it's...
But now the crosshair looks okay or works okay?
Yeah,
it
but it's...
Or no, it doesn't.
It
or
doesn't.
No, because I was too far.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's okay.
You think so?
Yeah, it was worse, like maybe someone changed it.
But maybe it could be, we could pick up the stuff farther, you know?
Yeah. I'm okay,
go.
Like maybe half meter or something.
Half meter, yeah.
Because this feels like I should take it,
mm-hmm.
But
yeah,
I cannot.
Yeah, exactly.
So another thing I notice, and someone told me this, that, yeah, when I think Tomáš, you told me this, that
mm-hmm.
when I turn the camera,
yeah.
There is this, I don't know.
It's definitely much more visible in the medieval engineers. That when you turn the camera,
spring.
It will auto. Yeah, there is a
yeah.
spring. It will
okay.
auto adjust always, and it's annoying. You know, when you want to play like competitively against someone when you want to shoot people, it's annoying. Because you don't have full control. But it doesn't, yeah. You see, there's this auto-adjustment there.
Yeah, maybe it shouldn't affect the cause, that should be it.
I don't know, it's weird, really. I mean, first, I don't remember. Yeah. I mean, Spring was definitely there, you know. But I don't remember this. And it doesn't look fast, and it actually should be moving fast.
Yeah, it's lagging, you know. It's...
And I don't know, like the guy, he's not rotating anymore, but the crosshair is.
Yeah.
And in this, okay, here it's not.
In medieval, when actually, you know, because most of the people in medieval will be fighting in third person. It's obvious. Everybody fights in third person.
Oh, yeah.
Like with a sword, you know.
In first person, you can better see the animations.
You can
better react.
Yes, exactly. You have a much wider field of view.
Yeah.
So that, you know.
No, I mean in first person.
First person.
Better reaction or animations.
Yeah.
At least for with boss fighting.
I was.
I haven't tried the PvP yet.
Okay, guys. So next thing. Maybe I will just finish the highlighting. So, do we already have this ability to highlight just some sub-parts of an object? Like, for example, I go to doors and only this panel will be highlighted or something like that.
We have this ability.
We have?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I will try.
I guess Lukasz was working on it today. I'm not sure if it's more than
if it's
well, it's programmed and we have ability to do it, but we haven't implemented it for all. Objects here.
And do you know which objects can do this?
Actually, not any objects that are in this game.
Okay.
They are just.
Okay, so next thing. Private versus offline analyze Pathhouse game respawn when alone. Yeah, so I think this is already working.
Yes. It's paused.
Although.
No,
are you sure it's paused?
No. But we are probably playing an online game. Otherwise, it would be a bit
Particles, they are not paused. Like, we didn't have this even in Minoverse. They were always pausing.
Okay.
But I think that's okay.
Music a bit.
Yeah. But why there is no this paused game? Because I saw it some in... I think medieval, you know, with the red text.
But
so it should be in both games.
Space,
so.
I've seen that post notification also in space. So probably it's not on that match. It should be there. On the top of the screen there is some game post.
Yeah. With red text.
I've also seen it in Slash.
Yeah. But maybe it was in medieval.
Uh-huh.
Like P?
Yeah.
Or you mean like this pause here?
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't even know we have this pause. Yeah, we should show this pause, even when this kind of pause, Tomáš, here.
Yeah.
And this is also weird when you pause like this. Okay, I think this is wrong. Like first pause is missing, but that I cannot unpause with escape, Tomáš. Like, you can go here, of course, but it's still paused, and when someone will not know what happened, he will think the game crashed or something. You know what I mean? So here, you should be able to unpause, of course, with pause, if we have it, and then also with escape.
Okay, so if you pause the game with pause, you should be able to disable the pause and escape.
So, what about this private versus offline?
As I remember it, currently, even if you are playing any mode that you are playing, until somebody joins you, you can still pause the game, even if you are playing online. Until somebody joins you, okay. And then you will not be able to pause it anymore.
Okay. And offline, in offline you
doesn't
can pause.
Matter. It doesn't matter if it's offline, if it's private.
And with friends and public you cannot also, you cannot pause.
You can pause and have all of them until someone joins you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, good. and respawn when alone. So what should I do? Yeah, I will just kill myself and I will see what happens. Yeah, and this rotating wheel. I wanted
it's
to change
already,
the code.
It's already my next priority.
Only it was changed today, but it's not mentioned.
It will have the same color as the text.
Yeah, Tomáš, do you hear?
Yeah.
We hear the sound. You know, this must be fixed also. You can put it there.
I think the connector is already in.
You see that? Do you remember how I told Tomáš Pusek to do it better?
Yeah.
It was exactly this case.
But it's because he loads up in the world and the load and the world is loading, you know, around him. Yeah, isn't like this. And but the game is not paused, you know, probably. So maybe you are loading into the world and
game is running, but render is still.
Game is running, but render is still. Yeah.
Completing something. So game must wait for render and then.
So it looks like a tank. Yeah. If you load it, then everything is appearing around.
Okay.
But
so
most probably we should just pause the game before the render is loaded.
What if you are playing multiplayer game?
Good question.
I think it's okay if when you get some notification from the render that it's finished.
Okay.
It's prepared.
And spawn the character there after it's finished. After the render is finished. Maybe you can spawn the character there.
But then you will wait again for
something
else.
Okay, so now it's F.
So before that, Marku. Before that, F.
Here's the new glass, isn't it? Yeah. Marco has shown me the new glass about the scratches today, but it's not on there yet. So.
And you will be able to open the doors when you just look at them, not just with this.
So, Joel, the glass.
I don't think. Have a look. This he showed me here. It was, no, it's not there yet. It's on a trunk.
Okay.
Yeah, it should be done.
And the reflections on that too, they look really, really good.
Oh, what a good, what the?
What the hell?
What the heck?
Have you never seen this happening before? What is this?
I don't know.
Is that an unknown lamp initiative for the last
one? Yeah, probably some bug use inertia lamp.
It didn't continue, it just kind of came up a little bit and stopped, which is really weird.
So you've seen this, Lukashi?
No, I haven't played it.
What the hell?
And also this one.
This is strange. But it must be some problem with the inertia lever.
Okay, and they are still moving, like, up.
Are they?
Yeah.
It might be an issue on that.
I mean, it's funny bug.
Yeah.
But it's weird.
This is why this doesn't go just tested.
So here I see old sound when placing stuff in the inventory. What does it mean? Like, let's test the.
Pick up something.
But is this new sound already, or is it one of those pieces that we are not sure of?
We need to see the video.
Because I don't remember seeing it. F.
You're not talking about this one, right? Okay, can we turn on the sound
for a few seconds? Because I cannot hear it.
Tomáš, can you do it more?
Yeah. Well, this is better.
You mean the sound?
Yeah. It was like it.
It's eating sound.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. No. So they designed this, or what is the story?
Oh, you didn't like the old sound. I gave them a ticket to change the sound. I have returned to the sound, and it's already in the game. Mm-hmm. That's the problem.
So please tell them to change it to something. I don't remember what sound was there originally in space.
It was this beeping, like weird.
Okay.
That's why we wanted to change. But maybe we can do the usual loop.
At some point we had a good sound for this. It was just like or something like this.
Or maybe the sound of putting something into your pockets could be fine also.
Something like this, like basically some textile sound. And I think we already had
textile this. Sound, yes.
I think we had this. So, shift 1, 2, 3 makes you change et al. So, okay, what is the change? You know, like shift 1, 2, 3.
How it is
now? In
control.
Control.
Control 1, 2, 3.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But still. You know, like if someone will do this by mistake, they will not know how to get back.
So maybe we can just put control plus next to the numbers, like ctrl plus, and in the same way as the numbers, so they will notice.
Or just the arrow keys.
What?
Arrow keys, yeah, the arrow keys also work.
What?
The arrow keys.
Arrow key.
Yeah, just go these two.
Yeah, but the problem is that this is even worse. Like if someone will do this, you know, by mistake, he will not be able to get back.
And in the G screen, for example, can you click on the mouse on the tab on the toolbar and select it with mouse?
No. Although you should be able to do that.
That's one thing.
What do you think? But you know, because we changed it, because when you were pressing shift and running, and you pressed some of the
numbers. I know, but I was actually expecting some, like not say bigger change, but more fundamental change.
Uh-huh.
You know, not just changing key to some control or something like this, but riffing it into a way where this mistake can happen.
Mm-hmm. Well, first off, what I wanted.
I mean, the best would be actually if there wasn't a need for additional toolbars. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But what do you think about this scrolling with that
mouse?
First off, scrolling with mouse, yeah.
Yeah, that can be good, but we just need to think about conflict with the scrolling for zooming out camera. Mm-hmm.
Press Alt.
Also,
you have to move the press Alt for zooming out.
Yeah.
Camera.
Really?
Which is
but it's not like this.
Option, so it doesn't make perfect sense.
Yeah, but I think I will do this because rotation is with Alt.
Yeah.
And also this would be with Alt. So, the scroll bar will stay for this thing.
Mm-hmm.
It could work.
We have in manual, we use all the stick with the blocks when you place them, and we are thinking of implementing this into space as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, save lots of space.
And space is about holding control, right? If you copy something, you hold control and zoom to make it closer.
Control, okay, still
control.
So guys, please rethink this in your interface redesign thing.
Okay.
And so, you want to have more hints or extra buttons or?
No. I would want something which is like how to say this, like fail proof or because if we solve these things by adding more hints or more keys or something like this, you know, it's like not fixing the source of the problem but the consequences of the problem. It's like, I don't know, like instead of living healthy or something like this, you know, taking pills so you know, like I cannot remember this word, but I really can't remember. But they say this, like doctors say this thing, mm-hmm. like fixing this instead of this. Mm-hmm.
Well, I know what you mean. The thing is that we can't do anything with the mouse. Like if you could, for example, do a go down and click some arrows, all you can do is basically not have it at all, or actually go into a menu where you check something, or you would have to, after 10 seconds, always go to the first one.
Like I don't want to hold the Twitch, so think about these guys. But definitely not by adding more hints and more checkboxes where you need to, you know, do something with this. And then also think about this scroll, you know?
Or maybe, Marek, this could be a solution, because this is quite a basic control of any player, you should know. And your problem is like when newcomer comes there and press the accidentally switches to toolbar 2, he can build anything and he doesn't know what is happening, mm-hmm. and he will quit the game probably.
Exactly.
So when, let's copy the paste to the toolbars on every position, and later player will know how to use them, so they will modify it.
It's actually...
This could work.
Yeah. So play with this idea. Yeah. So yeah, I'm not saying this must be the best solution, but it looks good. Yeah. So this kind of solution, you know, like iPhone solution basically. You know, not solving things by adding more and more controls and options and checkboxes, but by kind of like reducing stuff and basically not allowing player to do some stupid mistake. Mm-hmm. So yeah, another thing I notice here is, but guys, sorry, also look on the scroll wheel, mm-hmm. this thing.
Yeah.
And another thing I noticed is that why is this happening with the, you know, with the box, with the block, that it's inside, and now it's okay, it's being aligned, it's snapping like this, but here in the shadow, it's doing this thing. It's a bug or it's a feature?
It's just a bridge.
Yeah,
because you're not looking at the gauge there. But at the bullet it should snap. If you like look up, then it will snap.
Yeah. So, maybe
try not to snap too. Very well.
But it's really weird anyway. It shouldn't be like this, I think.
Yeah. And another thing, is someone finishing placing of these new blocks? Tomáš, you know, like we started this, but we didn't finish it.
Somewhere in the priorities, but I don't think it's Marek's priority.
So add it there, please, on Marek's priorities to finish this thing. And let it make very similar for space and Mediva. And another thing I think I notice is that if you look on the shadow behind these hints, mm-hmm. I don't feel like... It looks like, it appears to me like that the shadow is only under some portion of the text,
mm-hmm.
that for example here I see shadow here,
yeah,
but the text is here. I see shadow here.
Oh, so yeah, I understand.
Or something like this.
Yeah,
it's a drop shadow instead of being a shadow. That's
yeah, so it could be everywhere.
I don't think it was supposed to be like this. Mm-hmm. You know, I think
the text to the chat. I think people think it would look better as like a glow shadow.
But the shadow was supposed there to be to make it easier to read it on a bright background. And now basically half of the text is with shadow, the other half is not with shadow, you know, so you still have this contrast problem.
Well, the solution is just putting the shadow directly
behind
it.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's just like we are scaling up this shadow blob, you know, and not doing it right or something like that. So medical room was glitched when respawn ship on belly. Who is that?
When you landed in multiplayer and died, and then you respawned on the ship, and then it was upside down. There was like some kind of like glitching on the medical bay that it was like jumping.
Also, you could see through the landing surface.
Yeah. And I'm not sure it has been fixed.
So let's test this in a multiplayer. Okay.
Storm inbound.
Joel, can you please give me the pen? Thank you. Yeah, this was the wrong pen. Ah, okay, there was a pen. Thank you. Okay, profile and fix legs at alien planet. Okay, so I will leave this up to you. Add batteries for Y. What was that?
That you can turn off all the systems
okay.
on the ship.
So, okay, so, yeah.
Mark, people in the chat think that one pixel outline with black would be better than shadow.
Okay, so play with this. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a couple of comments about having an outline instead of shadow, which probably would make sense.
Yeah. So we can look on this, really. Because I remember that when we done this, it was just like a super quick fix, you know, so we can move forward. And maybe it's time to look on this more. It just needs to look, I don't know, like pretty. That's the only thing. So, spun rifle should be loaded with some ammo. Okay, I think this has been done sometime. Meteor storm should be set as default in survival. So I think that's true because there are some meteors.
But we are still having the meteors inside the planet, Peter. The problem with the meteors inside the planet.
Like they start in the planet?
Yeah, because sometimes they start inside the planet. Mm. You know? So there is like.
So fixing particles, walking over specific terrain, and spider blood. We will look on this on the particle meeting. Mm-hmm. A little bit better.
Okay.
Sound implementation, item pickup sound. So this will get changed. Moving items between inventories sound. Joel, can you turn up the volume? Mm-hmm. I don't know. I think it's not that bad.
Is that the super of the bust sound when you are scrolling in the menu? It's really bad when you are playing it on headphones. It's so annoying.
Mm-hmm.
Should have less bass, I think, or something.
It's quite loud. Definitely.
It's super loud.
I personally actually like this because you can do this stuff. You know.
You have a song.
But the only thing is it's all the last, so if you are playing on my headset that I have at home, I have to turn down all the volume because otherwise I cannot, you know, it's like...
Captain Vikingbeard said, it's a good sound. The Drake says, this sounds like someone's biting an apple.
You mean this inventory transfer?
Wait. Yeah.
Or it's like kissing or something like this.
It's like,
But some people then
So what I would actually suggest is that to work on this pickup sound that we discussed a couple minutes ago and maybe use the same sound for also this thing, you know.
I think it's the same sound.
And
I think it's the same sound.
Maybe. Okay. So it should be something like transferring sound or something like that. Maybe we had something like this in Minor Wars. I don't know, for
transcendence. It's passive, he hates the mouse herb sound.
So, okay, so for this, if people don't like it, then maybe just...
Well, there's people here saying, personally, they play that with all sounds off. Which is not really... Some people are saying they play the game with all sounds off.
Why?
I guess because, well, Luke Ash does play it too, and...
That's mostly because it's kind of the kind of game where you put a lot of time in and you just put on your own music. Especially if it comes for just
building. Is that because it gets annoying or just... Yeah, some sounds are too loud and goes right. It's not...
Which sounds do you think? This one?
Well, it's more like all of them sounds together.
Mm-hmm.
And some sounds are too loud, like Refinery or Assemblers are...
True.
They too much. Like volume in the game.
True, you can't hear anything else when you are standing like 5 meters or 10 meters from it. You can't hear anything else but the refinery.
Mm-hmm.
Jetpack.
It also got a bit annoying. I'm sure we don't know.
But and jetpack?
Apparently, if you switch off dampeners and silencing space, keep pressing space. Somebody hates the Gatling sounds, apparently, they make him angry.
Yeah.
And Gatling, you mean the handgun or this one? This somewhere here?
That one there. Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, but it should sound, you know, it should have something.
Yeah, in more detail, what do you hate about them, about the Gatling?
So, regarding the volumes, yeah, we should be speaking this.
Mm.
But this is up to Dominik and Lukasz. A
couple of people saying refinery is the worst.
Yeah, refinery is the worst.
Okay, so just tell them, you know, to explicitly to look on this. Maybe they...
Yeah. It's not necessarily the sound is wrong, but it's just sometimes too loud.
Yeah, yeah, so they can look on this.
Yeah. I want to talk.
Yeah, basically that's what people saying it's too loud.
Yeah,
people saying turret's too loud, that's the main problem. That's an easy fix. Refinery sound is
good. What? Everybody's saying good
about this. Refinery sound is jackhammer.
Character getting killed on ship, so that's another thing we'll look on in multiplayer.
He was actually also being killed when in single player.
And Tomáš, we have this multiplayer meeting planned, right?
Yes.
Okay, another thing which I don't understand is edit hacky speed comparison for character deaths. This should decrease deaths in ship. What is that?
Can I see?
Mm-hmm. Third one from the bottom.
Edit hacky speed comparison for character deaths. This should decrease deaths in ships. Yeah, it's because it's they did some fix in the physics that the character is actually moving like a bit faster than the ship. Because if it's moving in the same speed, exactly the same speed, it just, you know, gets the character being hit. Mm-hmm. He's hitting the ship and starts killing himself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that is why they said hacky, because it's not like realistic. You know, physics guys.
Okay. So right now the maximum speed of the character is a little bit bigger,
probably
faster than the
ship. When he's falling down, to this like holding on the ground in the ship.
Another thing, fixed object highlight blurring over grass. Do you know what that is?
Fixed. Yeah. Saying they love the change to F.
Yeah?
Yeah, no conversation about it, but there are some people.
So it's this? Meteor storm inbound. And what was fixed?
There is no offline around the grass.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
The grass
okay.
Was like
yeah.
Offline.
The highlights are way brighter now.
Yeah, I think good. That's good. And when we'll see this bruising effect?
Bruising effect plus the...
But when?
The outline here will be a little bit thicker. And it's not there yet. You know, so that you can see like glow. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but when we'll see that?
Bit.
Tomasz,
next
when?
Next week.
Okay.
I think it's already on track.
And another thing, like last thing for space is object highlight on some alpha mask materials. So what is alpha mask material like a tree or what?
Alpha mask materials, that's was especially for medieval, and it was those let's say for example food
branches.
Because
in space.
Yeah, because when you are highlighting them, they had like two different textures on themselves. Some of the parts of the texture would have been highlighted as well. Mm-hmm. So we have to fix that.
And can I see this in space? Is there some object that can see this?
Not ever. I've only seen it in the video.
Okay. Okay, so another game to look on is Medieval.
And we have this weird text bug now in space 2.
Yeah, can
you write that down to me, please? Because we should have to... Well, the weird text bug, again, is there. That part of the writing is...
Joel,
is
can you see it? Or do I need to switch?
Is it seen?
You have across the delay.
Oh, okay.
Seconds.
Probably not.
No.
Let's look on highlighting in Medieval.
Still starting in Survival, in Creative, Survival, I think. Or Creative, do you want Creative?
I think I wanted Survival, but then we discussed this and it can wait, you know, until Survival is more...
Alright.
...is better. Okay. And maybe until there is this Survival tutorial or something like that. And by the way, how is this planet for a medieval looking?
It's looking very good. So what? Once again? Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, it's coming up very well. It's actually it should be done in a few weeks.
Mm-hmm.
The prototype is ready. And the estimation is weeks. I don't want to overpromise to the fans. But it's not like half a year or some, you know, brutally long time ahead of us.
Joel, what is with the sound? Also, you can see it on his legs and everywhere.
But it should have already been fixed. I don't know why it's there.
And this is it fighting, so we already fixed it all? Tomáš?
No.
There are still some situations where it can happen?
Yes, if you, for instance, if you build stairs, and take a wall
Well, the thing is that Chesmere had some idea, but the thing is that it would like highly increase the performance problems. So he had to kind of scrap it and wait until something is done with the rendering.
And do you know what was the idea?
The idea was that he was randomly moving the mesh in the render, so that always one of them was actually above the other, so you couldn't see the Z-fighting.
Actually, it's not a good idea.
We are discussing this month ago, but I don't know where it is now.
Mm-hmm.
The thing is that there is some optimization from Marco, and if we actually did this, it would mess up the optimization.
Mm-hmm. And do you know better what kind of optimization? So, guys, can you write this also down?
Mm-hmm.
Basically, Z fighting and finishing it, and so Petr can talk with Marco and this.
Is it still there? Because I don't see it.
No, it's not there. Maybe some other combination, it will be visible.
It's still there, but only in minor cases.
Mm-hmm.
But it's still there.
And but what I notice is, okay, did you see this rotating wheel while the game was saving?
Yeah.
I saw something.
Hmm?
I saw something, but I was looking somewhere else.
Yeah. So basically,
when the game was auto-saving, he was like auto-saving, please wait, I don't know, like the usual stuff. And then underneath, there was also this rotating wheel. Actually, I don't know how does it get there. How did it get there?
We never had this, you know, when we in Space or Medieval. So I don't know who added it there.
So you don't want the wheel to be there?
No, definitely not. It should be just this text, you know, like some lock message or something.
Mm-hmm.
And for Space and Medieval,
so
it should
it's
be
a bit
the same.
Like disturbing, or yeah, shouldn't be. Shouldn't the game should not be molesting you when you're playing it. If you put it now should be some that fighting still, yeah.
And this is not does someone want to know what kind of shape is this red thing? If it is just like we are rendering the mesh?
No, it's built blocks.
So it's all like in this situation, no matter what kind of stuff do I have or I want to. Okay, so it's like this. Mm-hmm.
Because only billboards support transparency.
Mm-hmm. How to fix this, you know, so that this thing doesn't happen?
Maybe the stop bigger or use ZBS, which is just we're using for that purpose. I suppose he started to use ZBS for solving the depth fighting.
Mm-hmm.
And if he uses it too much, it will get above the billboard.
So I made screenshot, Tomáš.
And you don't like those stones sticking out?
Yeah. And
the reason why it's there, you know, these stones here, the reason is that there is this mesh.
Yeah.
Of course, these stones are a little bit like outside of, the cube. And then we render the cube with just 6 red transparent.
Mm-hmm.
Polygons or squares or something, but they are kind of inside these stones. You know, so it's basically not a bug, it's nothing like this, it just doesn't look pretty. And Petr says that we can solve this by this offset or bias or something, so then the Z-buffer will not be so,
We will move the square just a little bit outside.
But the question is if there are some other blocks where it will be more visible. Maybe not.
So what's next? Wording in crafting is weird. Okay. Yeah, it was this like item type. So here it's like fixed, you know, but it doesn't look that someone has changed this.
No, that's the sound of the graph was weird.
No, here is wording.
Wording?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I think, by wording we meant this, Tomáš.
Yeah.
You know, item type.
Okay, I'm sorry, I didn't know about this. I thought it's the items. Now it's choose templates instead, but templates doesn't sound very good also for the
and
I'm
so.
Sure. But okay, so it's about this list, so I will change it.
Okay, so instead of item type, there should be.
So let's start with this first one. Why is there my name?
Because you can craft from your character mm-hmm. or if you are operating some crafting table, for mm-hmm. example, you can switch to crafting mm-hmm. table and craft there.
But this doesn't apply anymore in that.
It's only
you
design.
Okay, so this will disappear.
Yes.
Okay. But this will stay there or not?
Yes.
Okay. Because otherwise you would see too many things here.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And do we expect that there will be more things than I don't know how much is
20?
Yes, because if mothers want to add more stuff, they could have like 30 swords.
So there will be a scroll bar or
yes.
Okay.
It should also be divided by the item types, I think.
So like the usual way how we were solving this, guys, was that there were these tabs here.
Exactly.
You know, for space or something like that. I'm not saying we must do it like that, but...
The thing is, because we will have several different crafting sources from which you can craft, the question is if it will have so many different types of objects that we will even use the, you know, 3-4 icons.
So what do you think? Put there the stubs, just like in space? It was somewhere in space, I remember, in some of these screens.
Yeah, but they would have to be moddable. Right now, these categories are moddable, so mm-hmm. you have to allow people to mod the icons
okay.
for the tabs and stuff.
Yeah, or maybe just keep it as it is, because combo box is definitely less work than these icons.
Yeah, yeah.
And think about this, you know. Then think about if choose templates is the best wording.
Yeah.
Requirements probably is. But when we will have this new GUI system, it will
yeah.
be probably better to redo this little bit more, you know,
mm-hmm.
so it's much more clear that, because right now it's crafting and inventory and it can be confusing for some people and also for me. So another thing is you should be able to fight without stamina. So what does it mean?
You have to go to survival. What is this?
So I cannot have a sword here?
You can,
yeah, okay, I get it.
There
mm-hmm.
is no
By the way, why was there this notification about saving two times? Wasn't it notification from the previous world or it's a bug? Like we saved the game two times right now or? So here, I could see like saving and it was on two lines. And I'm not 100% sure, but I think it was actually saving like the same name.
You can press F5. Is it accepted? No, like Shift F5. Yes.
Yeah, and it looks like this thing was there two times.
Mm.
I don't know. I will load this world again.
Maybe now it's written that you are saving the world.
Yeah. So please, someone look on this. because if on the first line would be saving, you know, like the previous one, that would not make total sense, but at least some sense. But this doesn't make sense.
Still, you are over the
saving. So just wanted to check the sound here.
And we don't save the game after the load.
Probably. If it shouldn't be visible.
Yeah, but still, why would we save the game after the load?
If it is quick start, then we save the from different sources.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The project of what?
It's a little loud.
It's loud.
It's fine. It's fine.
So now the stamina, I mean, I know that I said that it should refill faster. Okay, guys, change someone this this message.
Have you seen the blinking clot?
Yeah.
So now we have it in the middle too, nice.
What?
It was a blinking clot. A blinking, you know.
Yeah, I know, I know.
Blinking, not a lot, but the voxel.
So
yeah,
again.
Does this computer have updated graphic card drivers?
Joel.
Joel?
Are there like some updated NVIDIA drivers?
So I think so, it's up to date.
Yeah.
Looks the same one.
Like it's the same one as everything else.
Yeah.
Mm. But on some different computers, I noticed that the middle looks quite different. Darker or lighter. It's
it's actually funny because it says the FPS is 100, UPS is 60. But it doesn't feel 60. Like,
well, it doesn't because it's sluggish when you move the camera around.
There are these little lugs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. These little spikes and these little sluggish.
Shall we have the card?
Okay, so back to the stamina. So I wanted the stamina to refill faster, but now it feels a little bit strange because it's like I don't have this stamina, but only for like if I like lose all the stamina, I'm without it for let's say like half a second, and then I suddenly have it, you know. So I would actually say like, don't start refilling the stamina for 1 or 2 or 3 seconds or something like this. You need to feel, you know, the right amount, and then it will refill very fast. But right now it's really strange.
Okay.
I think Dušan made this as a really quick fix.
Yeah.
Well, you thought about it, right?
Takes a bit of coding. Yeah, well, it's being made.
You see, this is the here is the game post.
Ow. Yeah, I see. I see. So here we have hitting Barbarian doesn't sound like hitting Flash. I think it was meant to be hitting with the X or this thing.
Yeah.
And I think it.
You already told the guys what kind of sound you want.
Yeah, yeah. And but it's here like fixed, but I think it's not because maybe it's some mistake.
Yes, because they fixed it with the old sound. We remember that. We have heard it and we told them that the sound should be different. Last week. And Joao is working on this. Haven't you, Joao?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so the sound doesn't sound like change, like it's still sounds like a sword.
Yes. This will be changed.
So, yeah, but again, it's here, like, it was fixed, you know, so it shouldn't be here. It shouldn't be here.
Okay, so you want to have the sound specific for the weapon, if I understand.
Yeah, but Dominic knows this, because we told him this. So I think Dominic knows everything he needs to know about this. It's just like, it's probably by mistake on this list.
Mm-hmm. But let's say, do we have a specific sound for the sword and for axe? Do you want this different sound for mace, hammer, and all these things?
Yeah. Where it makes sense, then yes. Because right now, the axe feels like you can hear this, you know what I mean. And when you will hit someone, like, you can try this with an axe, it doesn't end with, like, you know, it's like,
or like,
but here it's like,
Yeah.
Telling the player he ran out of stamina, so that's there. Crafting should have a shortcut, okay? A diagonal stick into wooden floor model. What is that?
That's some fix of a model. I'm sorry, probably shouldn't have been.
Okay.
It's in
the
roadmap, but not in
the deer run faster and has bigger alert radius. So where are these deers actually? Can I find him somehow?
On planes, you can find it easily. On creative, you can spawn them.
Mm-hmm. You can turn on the button,
Yes. It's like clicking. We think we should rethink about spawning the deers because they are spawned somewhere on the.
Yes, it will be different.
Yeah.
Daniel is working on that.
Mm-hmm. So mine stones are spawned with different sizes. I will just go on light because it's too dark. Tomáš, the last time we were discussing this, we decided that, like, when you will be digging with the axe, you will be taking the rocks and stuff immediately, or you will need to pick them up.
Pick them up.
Yeah, that's what you wanted.
And you mean with the hand tool.
Yeah. So and plus, I think the rocks should be smaller. I think this will be different on planets, right?
Well, it depends on the length of one day.
Maybe
what will be different on planets? Sorry.
The shadows, because they are moving really fast.
Yes, it's going to be different. And now we have set the time of the day of 20 minutes, so we have to be like also super fast.
I think the rocks, like, first they should have a random size.
They already have random size.
Yeah, but bigger variation.
You want bigger variation? Okay.
But then it collides, it can be mistaken by the small stone.
That's the only problem.
And what is small stone?
Just cut one, swing once to the large stone you dig up.
Okay.
Small stone is needed for, let's say, like basic equipment.
This shouldn't happen.
This is a nice explosion.
Can you maybe save the game? Because it's really hard to reproduce this stuff. Maybe the card is in a specific way, like upside down. Just say bug.
The one bug.
Two times.
So auto-save for your save.
Yeah. Okay. So, Tomáš, when I save this save as, you know, I could see two log notifications about, like, the world was saved, like, this thing. So, come on. So why we cannot have
what?
Small stones there? What is wrong with them?
Well, the really small ones are used for tools and some other basic equipment, and the big ones are used for the walls and stuff like that.
So maybe we just mix them, make small and large stones and spawn both?
Mm-hmm. But then we want to have this progress that with like simple tools you only get the small stones.
Mm-hmm.
And to get like big stones you need to have like better devices and equipment.
No, I mean with mining you would get both, but if you were collecting you would get only small ones.
Yeah, but if you'll be hitting the rock with, let's say, stone axe.
Okay, just it means I guess that 10 small stones will fill one large stone, for example.
No. Oh, we can talk about it later.
Okay, yeah, because this is also different coverage. But yeah, all the tools will be better if you have correct tools for better materials.
And why do we need better tools for making bigger stones? Like, if I'm thinking about this, you know, like a normal guy, I don't see a reason, because if I want stones, I will just go, you know, like, to nature and get them. And I will not see a difference, or, like, it will not take me any longer to find big stones or small stones. Like, you can go to any river, you know, and just get any kind of, any size of rock you want.
Yeah, but try to get a big stone from a rock, like, from a big rock.
So, again, to get smaller rocks from a big one, or...?
No. In our game, you can only get small stones... Well, you can get stones only from where they are. We don't have any laying stones around or something like that. So the small ones are gained from, let's say, grass rock, because you can actually see them in the texture. And with... Well, you can get them anywhere else. And to actually gain big stones from, like, the mountains, from the big rocks, you have to have a tool, because... Imagine you have like a basic tool and you want to take a huge stone from a huge rock. You need to have good devices to do this. Like good tools.
Okay. Can you write this down only as another thing we will discuss on a meeting? And we'll discuss this and...
To me?
If you can think about this a little bit more. And the point is that... As Tomáš is saying, this is, it doesn't sound like something based on reality. You know what I mean? I don't know, it's like right now, if I wanted small or large rock, I would just go, as I said, like to a river or to a forest or... And okay, even if there are no laying rocks around, like in our game, like in reality they are, but let's say that they are not, so I need to dig them up. I still don't see a difference between getting big or small rock.
Well, if you don't have, let's say, metal tools, you won't get them out, because if you have like a stone axe or just a stone, you will destroy the stone against the rock. That's the thing.
And also there is a game perspective, which is good to
you will you destroy it, but but still it's you will also destroy it if you want to get a small rock,
yeah,
you know, from the ground.
To me it makes a bit more sense so that the stuff has more durability and maybe you can like faster with it if it's a bit better quality.
Okay.
So how do you get a rock in our game if you don't have the tools? Of course, but how do you mine it without the tool?
We still don't have the iron. But it depends on how the iron is going to be implemented.
Yeah, but if you start in the game with your bare hands, you know, that was the point.
Mm-hmm.
How do you get to some useful tools? So you don't need to punch, you know, the rocks like in other games.
You go to an area where there is a stone material and there is a stone grass or grass underscore stone. And you can actually see small stones in the box. And you can get the small stones from this material.
And it's already here?
No.
Oh.
And the small stones, they will be normal. So it's not already in the game. Okay. And these small stones, they will be like 3D objects or some fake stuff in texture?
They are 3D objects. Okay. They're just not really that much use.
And have you thought about performance and stuff? Like if these small rocks will not hurt the performance, you know, physics.
Yeah, but if we are going to go the way that we talked on the meeting on Friday, we can remove them quite quickly. If the player won't pick them up, they can just disappear. Mm-hmm. It's not, because if it's... If
okay, so they will not be lying there all the time.
It's not the physical object, I guess.
Okay.
It's the same object as when you dig out those big ones. It's the same thing, but it's smaller. Mm-hmm. And it is so like different from mm-hmm.
So we can kick it? Yeah. It would be better if we have just two materials, one with the stone, and then when you use the action, replace it without stone material. Well, to save spawning objects around it.
If it's based on the gameplay and we test it, then fine, but we are just like talking about something.
Yes, of course. It's not.
But so far, I've been trying it and there's no problem. It has been there, but we are not using the small stones for any crafting. You can just mine the big ones from, like, let's say, soil or grass or anything.
So again, to these big rocks, to me it... How do I change the daylight, by the way? Daytime.
Survival, or something. You need to press the cheat first, I guess.
Why is there always night in this game? Like, every time I play, there is night.
You probably start in the afternoon, so that's why there is night soon. Exactly.
I thought we are starting in the morning. Maybe it's a quick start.
So, Tomáš, maybe another problem I have with this is that it appears to me that when I'm digging, I get more rocks, like the volume of this rock is bigger than was the actual voxel volume. You know, so it feels like we are just creating material.
Mm-hmm. That depends on like how we want to go with the performance. For let's say, we can either make buildings cheaper, and we can give player less amount, so that he actually makes less changes to the environment. Or we can give him more materials, have buildings too expensive, and have less editing of the voxels.
I would make it that we'll spawn less rocks from this thing, but in building you will need less rocks to build the stuff. So there will be this kind of hack, if you know that.
Okay,
like you told me, like make like you will have some tree, and you will make more logs out of this tree than in reality you would. So use the similar thing here.
The thing with stones is that then you might need only like 3 stones to make a huge 2.5 cubic meters of stone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is that fine with you?
Yeah.
Okay.
If that's fine also with you guys, then I think it's okay.
I'm sure I need to play it first. But yeah, compared to this, what we have right now would be better, much better.
And does someone know where do actually we get 3D models for these rocks? Because it's possible that it's the same model that was there since Minor Wars or something like this, and we are just scaling it up or something like that. Maybe it's just one rock with some random scaling.
Yeah, I think it's like that. It's the floating object model.
Yeah.
It's used even in space when you spawn some material. You drill into voxel.
Maybe we need more variation. I mean, as I told you, Tomáš, there should be less rocks out when you dig like this or something else. You know, or in other words, like the when we cut out some voxel content, we should not spawn more material than we actually cut out. I would actually say let's spawn half of it or even less, because something is like a debris or like a garbage, you know, that you don't collect.
That's big problem because then you will mine half of the mountain to build a castle, for example. You know, so you will modify the save file, and the save file itself, if you load it in multiplayer, it will grow much higher, for example.
I don't understand.
Well, because the voxels will change, and every changing voxel is, how to say it,
it's increasing the save file, and it takes longer to load.
Yeah, but you are already digging. I mean, like.
Yes, but you are gaining more materials, so you don't need to dig that much as you would.
No, no. Like from this perspective, nothing will change. The cut sphere or what we are doing there will do the exactly same, you know, and except we will spawn less of these rocks, you know, or they will be smaller. Like it will. It must make more sense, you know. So if there is, like, I don't know, you will cut a voxel material that is of a size, let's say, of this chair here. Now it appears to me like we spawn this bunch of rocks, you know, like you dig something which is of this volume, and suddenly there is like something like this. So it's almost like a magic.
So the model will be just smaller, or it will just match the hole you dig, yeah, but the amount you will get the same.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. And also the cut function will cut the exactly same amount of voxels as it's cutting right now. So the voxel change will not change, it will stay as it is, and only this 3D spawn rocks will change, so they will be more realistic to the situation. And another thing, Tomáš, please make a note and let's ask someone who will find out what kind of model is it, and if it is just one, and we are modifying it, you know, by this scaling and so on. And maybe we should add a few more models. Like, it's not a big problem because to model this rock, it's even the texture, I think, is procedural. So some rocks will be more sharp. You know what I mean? Because now they are too perfect, all these rocks.
Also, the sharpness will mean that the physics change of the object.
No, doesn't. But the collision shape can stay. It's probably box or sphere or something like that, so it can stay.
Yeah, but then, you know, you could see the sharp rock, which is rolling like a sphere. Wouldn't that
I don't know, we'll see.
Okay.
So do you want the artist to do more stones or programmatically generated stones?
No, artists. Yeah. And but only like two or three, you know. Don't let them make like 50 or something.
Stone museum, we could have them.
I like how the lighting looks now. It's in the morning.
So the last thing for medieval is barbarians give more priority to player and can attack and block near an unreachable player or something like that. I don't know.
Yeah, that was the distance between player and barbarian. It should match the hit zone. Like, you want to get the feel that he swing with the tool and hit you while you were too far, for example. They were attacking you.
Are you sure? Because here this thing talks about priority.
It's more about picking target function.
Yeah, it looks like AI stuff. But then the other half looks like you're saying, like, can attack a block near, it's some broken English here, but can attack or block near an unreachable player, I don't know. It sounds weird. Who is writing these things? Tomáš? Okay, so we'll ask him. So guys, what, I will just go, you know, do some business. I will be back in a few minutes and think about what should we do next. Joe, what was the plan?
Play some more games.
Mm-hmm. We also wanted to play a dedicated server.
Yes.
So let's think about this. Or some other games. Probably some other games, right?
I think so.
Okay, I'll be back. So maybe someone can do something for a few minutes. Guys.
Who should I?
Okay. Hello.
No, this is secret.
That's fine.
Take a better weapon.
I will do 360 scopes. Oh, there. The crosshair change.
Yeah.
Do you like it, Red?
Hmm?
Do you like it, Red?
Well, it's... It doesn't need to be red, but yeah, we were... It's up to discuss.
Yeah, well, we can do the change of the shape. Just... What? Headshot.
Yeah. No way. There is no way to hit them on that distance.
How did you get there so many barbarians?
Magic. He actually used the debug screen.
Oh. Maybe space on medieval. Yeah, sorry, space on dedicated server.
Okay, yeah.
Whatever is up to date, okay.
Right, I guess I'll leave you guys.
Should we switch to normal game and not
death? Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. In the meanwhile, maybe I will start as Subnautica. Who does play this game? Who knows it?
The chat wants to see. I think last time there's a lot of people asking.
I know. But I mean, who can help us? You know.
I can't.
Hmm.
See what people. We want to see, guys. What game? space engineers, or do you want to see Subnautica?
There is Subnautica.
Star Citizen, Ark.
Scrap Mechanic.
Scrap Mechanic, yeah. Let's see what they say. Okay,
this is actually good. Rise of the Tomb Raider. It's the new Tomb Raider. Okay, I can launch it.
Evans.
I hope I will have my saves here.
Everyone is saying SE, but you can, I guess we can do it. Just check it.
Okay. The stream, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's
got
this.
Game capture, and then if you right click it, fresh, fresh. There you go. Don't do this to me. I tested Tomb Raider earlier as well. Just press refresh again. Okay. Oh, I know. Okay, that's okay then. And then maybe untick space and leave. It actually might come back up when you go into the game. If you go into the game, it's sometimes. Yeah, there we go.
A new Tomb Raider. And look on the snow. Nice. And also the texture is actually good. Like you can see these little sparks on the snow. Yeah. This is very nice. And then the ice here, like on the right side.
Lara.
two prints in the snow. It's really nice.
Nicely done.
Yeah, this is nice jump animation. Sure, because this was also possible in the last one.
Yeah, but it was kind of, you know, like very limited.
Yeah, yeah. But maybe also this is limited. Actually, many moments in this game when something like this like these animations or these scripted animations happens, and you need to press something and you don't actually know what to press, so you die. You need to replay and replay and replay. Like,
I think
this is the biggest like flaw of this game, that it gets annoying, but other than that, it's perfect.
But they have the same start as the previous Minecraft. You were going, squeezing between those two rocks and somebody grabbed you, and you were crouching, kicking him, and this situation would be like, yeah.
Yes.
the categories.
It's actually good that now when she's hurt, she cannot jump, she cannot run. It's like our, this is auto stamina thing. I mean, not exactly, but. So I still need to kill the bear. So I will just shoot him.
Stab him, that's a waste of
his fire. Probably broken or something.
Because it's behind you, I think. Yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. Thank you.
Make sure that the guy collects the mushrooms and just place it into the cave in front of the
cave. Yeah.
Reckoning of the
what?
So Some people say uranium glow sticks, like on the. Or the glow sticks made out of 2 units of silicon.
Is there a way how to turn off, or is this, you think the game could be done without this screen, which shows you the path? Does the game lead you somehow?
Yeah, it shows you like the next thing or something.
Yes, but without this screen, because it's what kind of breaks the area.
Yeah, it will be harder to find these things probably. Actually, it's good to see how they are doing the highlights, because it's similar thing that we were just discussing, guys.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not just highlight, that, you know, it's like our highlight, you know, the simplified, but it's, there is some shading in it and so on. Looks like I have 11 in the inventory, right?
Two.
Two arrows, but the cost, the resources you need.
Two out of two. Full.
I still don't understand, it's kind of confusing.
Mm.
But it looks like it's two of two. Okay.
Yeah.
It's written big.
I don't know why they have it like this. It looks like this is a problem or something. The ammunition is actually full.
Yeah.
Also, I need these feathers.
The capacity for the poisonous.
I still don't get it. And
yeah.
I don't like these tables, you know.
So that she could run away. Nice zombie line.
Everywhere I should kill her first. Wrong way, give her thrice. You better get a good shot.
Psycho killer. It was like this in the first part also. You begin like real slow and then you turn into a mass murderer. You kill like thousand people.
She doesn't care, does she?
Okay, so who should I kill next?
Is that best or not?
Set on fire the barrel. Realistic.
Že dělali tři a půl tisíce.
Okay, so what is next? I think I wanted to place space on a dedicated server.
We maybe start citizen.
So which one?
Click on players.
Yeah.
On the right side.
Just go to the busiest, I guess.
Yeah. The first or the second without mods.
Well, yeah. I think more than that. It's only 167 so far.
67 players.
No, no, no. On the server list, there's still quite a lot to load.
Yes.
Spanish one. Permanent same speed with Cylinder.
Excellent. 6 out of 100 is DevLDMs.
What's that all?
Czech engineers ping 440. What?
Don't
put it.
It's probably a home server, you know.
Where people
he's going to the home and it doesn't.
But
he's serving 9 people,
players.
so it's
still 9 players on this server.
That's
surprising.
Joe, so which one?
Take
the Spanish server because it's a lot of places there.
The Valhalla one's got a low ping, one of the lowest ping on the list. 15 people,
20
minutes. That's the people will start doing it. It'll get suddenly it's gonna fill up and everyone's gonna be like, what the heck?
Thank you.
There's a question somewhere, Mark. I want to know what your favourite colour is.
I don't have a favourite colour.
You don't have a favourite colour, okay. It's a random question.
I don't have a favourite colour. What's your favourite colour? I don't have a favourite colour.
Maybe black, because
black?
It's the colour of death. Death.
Black and red.
And I'm like... no, I'm just joking. What was that? Did you see it?
Yeah.
There was some weird screen.
It was screen that respawned.
What is this?
Yeah.
It's hard to tell because this server has 20 mods.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Jesus. It's in the game.
But I shouldn't have seen this.
Because they have spammer and death enabled, probably. Mm-hmm. So whenever you respawn, it new respawn chain, and it will, you'll lose ownership of all things you build.
Yeah, but now I'm respawning or spawning for the first time in the game.
Oh.
So this message book doesn't make sense.
Yeah,
Tomáš.
Can you mark it?
People wanted me to show you the LCD mod, the camera's LCD mod.
And where can I see it?
I'd have to install it. It's not a workshop mod. It's not compatible, but it's working, and people really like it, and they were interested to see your opinion on it.
It's the YouTube.
It's a YouTube, but it's
so maybe Lukáš, you can prepare this for the next time, if you want.
I mean, I can probably do it in like 5 minutes. Just get it off my computer. It won't take long to do.
So do it.
Okay.
Why is this thing so yellow?
Maybe your light is probably on.
You mean it's highlight the overlay?
Your lights.
But I'm in the cockpit, so... So they modded this response,
yes.
Okay. And where are the other people? So I can kill them.
I'll switch on the hat, maybe someone is signaling.
Okay,
that's
true.
So there was a question before if we should connect the space the debug cheats we have with the Space Master, if it's possible. So you will put the cheats, you will become the Space Master, so you can find the other players, teleport there, and interact with them.
Yeah, actually we are planning to do that.
Fine, that's nice.
Well, there are some in the 6 astronomic units of the space there. People.
So there are some people.
Yeah.
But they're too far.
Well, somewhere in our universe.
Mm-hmm.
There's something else coming.
Hmm?
Five meters above you.
Why is my maximum speed only 20 meters? Because
question.
I don't have, like, the power usage is 45%, so it's not strong enough, or?
Well, it's probably because server swing speed is very low. Server swing speed is 22, yeah.
so...
Simulation speed 1, server simulation speed, okay. Cheats work in a multiplayer. I would assume that they shouldn't, right?
They are not working like on this dedicated server. You have to be the admin.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. Then it had. I don't know. I was testing it about 2 weeks ago, maybe, and I can I could teleport.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
So, what is the cheat?
I can't tell you, but I don't.
So, okay, if you can type it here.
That.
Yeah.
Just let me know, Mark, when you want to do it, and I can just set up in like 5 minutes. So just get to play for this one for a bit. I'll send the link to myself so I can see it.
I can get off the cockpit. Ah, it's F, right. Okay, you are here.
So we go.
Teleport, yes.
Wow. Is this okay?
No. So we have been us developers, so maybe we should leave some possibility there to do this.
I just let the cameras down to the coming, and I was like, oh, quick, to the street. So I said.
Because in the future, anybody will use it to cheat.
Well, okay, but then we need to make it safer.
Yeah.
But okay. We need it. Can you grant this function? Oh, yeah.
Why it's not working?
Work like a ring bell.
What's his name?
Lots of turtles.
Is that him?
No planets?
No planets.
It's not him. He's like Mr. Vendor or something like that. Mr. Vendorit, yeah.
Just kill him.
Let's
kill him, yeah.
kill him with fire.
Kill the tree, there you are.
Should I kill him?
Yeah. Right.
We really need to do something, guys, with this weapons and shooting, because, like, you know, like, it didn't see that we are actually shooting him.
Yeah.
Like, there was no particle effect, there was no impact, like, it's just so
good. Yeah, that's why.
Yeah.
Thanks for killing after 5 minutes in this
Eric, you are not in best time.
Mm-hmm.
We are moving properly on a new server.
Okay.
We're moving our property.
They're doing something.
I think they're taking.
Yeah.
Thank you.
What is this?
Dance.
Is this right, I think?
Yeah. But if there would be these impacts, rectal impacts, it will be much better.
Stop shooting!
What?
Okay, so I need to kill more people.
So this
side, F8 is spectator. I can move really fast in that state.
A wild Marek has appeared. Marek just robbed a guy. Marek the bounty killer. Marek is no god. Marek is a demon. He's the money.
But shooting somehow hurts the server.
Bug Marek.
The bad something like, shut up, or I will shut up the server.
Bug Marek. I didn't see that. Stop shooting. Marek is bloodthirsty. Marek, you asked to hide the hints, the game hints.
Okay.
That's a good reason.
Can I cheat some more ammo?
Yeah, I think so.
Yes, we can.
Yeah, can I? It's maybe here? No.
No, Dusha, don't. That's not. That's not.
Okay. No, I think it's that. It can
it's
be
the same,
that.
Yeah.
It opens just a blueprint screen.
Yeah, okay, yeah, it's probably that's okay. Marek, that's now been quoted. I need to kill more people, Marek Rosa 2016. You'll go on to like the space of this loading screen.
So Marek, what are your goals for the next year?
By the way, what is wrong with this ship? Like the way it's moving?
I think it's still floating forward.
It's what?
It's still floating forward and the dampeners are hot.
And this is my ship?
Yes.
Okay. But sometimes, you know, like it jumps like close to us, or I don't know.
There's the same speed issue. It calculates the position of the ship and you and the compare it.
Didn't I want to do something with these doors?
Yes. We planned to. You will be able to move.
Yeah, it was one of these animation changes. They finally banned me.
Gulag Celset.
Gulag, no.
So this is good pink, but okay, it's full.
You can create a
is it even possible to have this pink? Like if it is even possible to have pink one, but maybe if they are somewhere in Prague,
maybe it's our colleagues playing from the office.
So maybe if we can kick someone from this server, then I can join, right?
Let's dance to their account.
Thank you. Well, they are. They are being escorted. It's just.
Guys, can we change this screen and add some more info?
Yeah, that's a good point. People have been talking about it recently.
Yeah.
Is there any way we can get like a progress, like 2 out of 5 mods downloaded? Because
I think we can do this for 4 mods. It shouldn't be that hard.
Interesting as well, people don't know why. Apparently every time this happens, it basically downloads all the mods every time you connect. Completely. So it re-downloads all the mods, which is why it takes so long. That's what I was told by people who know the...
Yeah, Thomas, so please also recheck this thing, because I don't think it was supposed to be working this way. You know, like the mods should be cached or...
The question, maybe we could implement these blueprints and mods thing, like everything on local, and add some auto-update of these things, so, you know, you will have to mod, download it once.
Plus also add some progress for the mods, because there is actually there are no mods, because there are 29. Okay.
It's a lot of mods.
It should only update the mod. It should only download when the mods have been updated. But apparently, it re-downloads them every time, which is why it takes forever.
It also depends on the server, how it's fast.
Yeah, but for people who have really bad internet, if they have to wait like half an hour, I've been hearing rumors of people waiting half an hour to download mods. Which is okay once if you've got bad internet, but to do it every single time, you know, it's quite strange. And because it's just that spinning wheel of like randomness, you've no idea how far it mod is.
Mm.
So it's like, yeah, exciting.
So what was that, Peter?
No idea. No response what they're available or something like that. No response points.
Yeah, but there was some strange white, I don't know, it looks like some pixelated game thing or something like that. Dropship.
This should be covered with the synchronizing of loading. And getting into game with sound, we discussed before.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Captain Viking Bird, who I killed, he's coming after me. So how to find other people here?
To ask them for GPS coordinates.
Yes. Just press K and look for the factions.
Well, you can look for factions, yeah.
Okay. Try to join any faction. Oh, maybe the factions are not disappearing when nobody is on the server from the faction. Which I guess it should. Fine. What is this? Why are there so many offline players?
Because it locks every offline, every player.
Everyone who once played there will be there in
the city.
So Marek, just write into chat and ask them for GPS coordinates that you want to join them. They don't know your... They just pray that they don't... I haven't seen your Twitch. Okay. But if we should build some exoskeleton, which would be undef... Well, you know, just you should dress as a boss, walk on the server and let them kill you. Of course, you will be overpowered, so... Finally, so.
Why is it called Mysterious Craft? They renamed it.
No, that's also server with mods.
Yeah.
Ah, I'm sorry. Yeah, you didn't make this.
Okay, so how do I take this GPS coordinate?
Just click on K.
Yeah, click on K. GPS.
Just
it's already there. It's already there.
The, here?
It's like to show
yeah.
It
Is it possible to get there with this kind of ship?
Yeah. What is the server sim speed?
50%.
But I'm also falling down, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So I'm not sure if I can make it.
You can make it. You just have to... Chceš to natočit takhle? Víš?
Like this?
Natočit si kameru. No, dopředu to dá, tak by se letěl vrtulníkem. Tak se takhle se s tou sviní, tak už to dopředu dáš a poletíš jakoby nahoru.
Zatím to teda vypadá,
že kdo... Teďka jako by let nahoru,
jakože...
Teďka dají jako ten, který space bar.
To jo, ale fakt to je pravdou. Protože ho nic nebrzdí. A tam panely jsou
tady tam.
Je takhle už jenom...
To je nejlepší způsob, jak vítat se bude.
Yes.
A víte, to je zpátky ten scaffolding.
Cože?
Just take the scaffolding.
The scaffolding. The
thrusters.
Co se scaffolding dělá? Also have the trees turned off.
Mm-hmm.
This is what they do on the press servers now. They turn off the trees.
And why are they doing this?
Performance.
And sim speed, server sim speed or something?
Just render performance.
Uh-huh. And who is optimizing the stuff?
Currently, like threes, over.
Mm-hmm. And render performance?
Marco.
But he's also bug fixing or something like that.
He's also leading bug fixing. And
I was thinking to myself, wouldn't it be great to have a guy focused only on performance, fixing other stuff?
Currently, he's working on Okuju Kalink.
Thank you.
maybe 60 minutes.
So, how does the teleport work?
I guess you need to exit from the exit of the cockpit. Mm-hmm. And maybe
take care about it also, because otherwise you're gonna smash the
cockpit. Yeah, exactly. You will die. So just turn on the.
Hmm?
Okay.
Exit the ship?
Probably, or just make it narrow, so activate the. Okay, I'll crush it. This is nice. And the permadeath means like...
We need to do something with these guys, because there was this moment when we died, then there was like you respawn in... No. Like... Just look on this from player perspective, because for a few seconds you don't know what happened. Like, of course you see that we died, but it's still, you know, there was some like or something like this. Tomáš.
Yeah. And just spacesuit, you don't need to drop ship. And press F8 to enter a spectator. F8, yeah. And now search for them, the GPS. With the mouse scroll you can, yeah. Yeah, and it's called Death Zone, so be careful. respawn a bit. And now go, yeah, to the surface. Slowly. Shift is just a little boost of the speed.
So how do I get here?
Now you need to turn the debug control 0 on the numeric one. Control and 0. Yes, and now control on space. And because you had some inertia speed in from space, I guess. So you teleported with the inertia and flew away.
Imagine you're playing all of a sudden a guy.
Yeah, just,
oh
my goodness.
Alright,
it's okay, it's safe, I'm sure. It's SESE, basically, server extender. Okay, now we just launch it like this, I believe.
What is so special about it that you need to run it from this file?
Because it's not a workshop mod, it obviously edits some stuff. There you go, look, server extender. Right, let me just find a...
Okay. But Tiresias basically made this mod to show that it can be done without having an impact on performance. So I'll set it up somewhere here. Okay. Well, it doesn't have to though. But you can, because you can disable it. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Well, you'll see. I would just. Okay. That's. So that's obviously seeing what the Gatling turret on the red ship is seeing. Couple of things here. So in the options, game options, yeah, he's got like a processing thing. So if you want to disable it completely, if you've got a lower end system, you can turn it off. So if I was to do that, and then it basically just stops and didn't work. But if I was to turn it to max, which I won't bother doing, that's basically, it takes more of the processes.
If you put it like 100%?
It only gets to 50, because that's basically how much of your GPU, or I believe, you give to this mod. Now if you add more cameras, so if I just add another LCD here, and put another camera, let's say, interior turret, this one here. Notice how each one gets like laggier. But how this works is you can have like priorities. See it, Honda? And that's about.
There's no feature in this black.
Oh. Everyone's that's why you always check. The hell?
Oh, sorry.
They should have told me quicker, Lukasz. talking about the LCD mod, okay. Okay, it'll be there in a second. Let me find something else, like how about the right camera? That's just a static camera. Sorry everybody, I didn't know about that. If I put a camera in this room, and then say we'll change this one to remove that and put the Gatling on that one. And on this one, we'll put the camera that I just built. And you could have them like switching between the different cameras if you like. So now. See how it's slightly laggy? But if I wanted to prioritize that one, I can go down to the camera here. And camera priority times 10. So now this one will be smooth. Oh, if I can actually come down here. And then use, so now this one here will be, you know, but the other ones will be slower. But these other ones don't necessarily need to be smooth, because you can kind of still see what's going on there. So if an enemy ship came, you'd be able to see if it's coming. But you could have 100 cameras and it wouldn't get any more laggy, because it basically takes on the same processing pool. So if I was to turn up this setting here in the settings to max, every single camera will now be smoother. So if I go on Shift F11, now I've set it to max, the FPS is like 60, around 60, but if I was to return it to 15, and that's the max the GPU is allowed to spend on this, it goes up to 90. So you can control how much this affects your performance. Yes, that's the basic thing of it. If I was to attach it to a ship here, the whole, let's quickly attach it to a blue ship, or this little thing over here. Okay, now if I
I come over here first. So you could use this as like a security feed, so you could have one of these like switching between all your Gatling turrets to see if there's any enemy ships coming. If I switch this one here to use, let's have a look, this one here I guess. So now we're looking at what the blue ship sees. So I'll just bring my camera in here, like this, and now I'll fly out to that ship, but control the ship from the LCD screen. There'll be some issues with LODs due to it not rendering properly, but now if I go to F8, so that's what the ship sees, and now, okay, and if I fly over to this, obviously it's in the front of that. Hopefully this Gatling turret will see me when it rotates. There I am. The top left there. So the point is, if you want a camera that's smooth, so you can do like refined movements, it's good to have the priority on 10. But cameras like security cameras can update slower. So there I am. On multiple screens. So that's basically it. And people have made mods in cockpits, so you can have I think you can have like screens come up in your cockpit of like different areas of your ship. So Tier Assist has basically unlocked a lot of potential for modders to do some crazy things with this. So yeah, ultimately it can have an impact on performance, but now again, if I was to go to game and say I had a terrible graphics card, I could completely turn it off, and the pictures, well, they actually are updating very slowly, but my FPS is now 120. That's the main reason why I like it. If you want to have it and want to use it, I think Armor Free has it where you basically, there's an option in the settings to disable PIP, so it's basically the same as that. Do you disable or enable picture-in-picture? I've now disabled it, so they shouldn't update at all now. Yeah, and it's just funny, it's actually left it there, so you could almost take a picture and it would stay on there. I'll just, yeah. And in fact, if I...
Okay.
Yeah, that's about it, yeah.
Sorry about it.
What people saying was, I don't miss anything.
Okay.
So yeah, you're just F. And this works actually fine in multiplayer, so someone could be in here watching your every movement. Press F6.
Are we going to disable this highlight on LCDs?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Tiris has also managed to show a browser open. He also managed to show a browser. He was able to watch YouTube videos in-game.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. By basically, yeah, which is pretty awesome.
Okay, Joel, I think we can wrap it up for today.
Okay.
It's almost 10.
Yeah.
Okay, so goodbye guys and see you next week.